Praise the Lord. We give God all the glory. Today is another beautiful day. By His grace, He has led us throughout the week. We pray that the Lord Himself will have His way today too. Precious Holy Spirit, please speak to us today too. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed with thanksgiving. Brethren in the Lord, I welcome you today to the program, How Do You Understand the Word of God? I am the handmaid of the Lord, Evangelist Mrs. Jacqueline Enin. We'll take our devotional reading from Daniel chapter 1, verses 1 to 8. This story talks about Daniel and his friends, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And we know that these were young men who had been captured from Judah to Babylon. Nebuchadnezzar gave orders to his chief of staff to select men who were from the royal family and then to feed them well and then train them in their language. Brethren in the Lord, this is a nation who worship idols, but they wanted the best. And these men were chosen from the royal, from people who come from the royal house or the royal palace. So what I see here is that what the Holy Spirit is drawing my attention to is that even the devil wants strong men. He wants people he can use. He wants people that have talents, people who are well-versed, people who he can train. But God is counting on us to draw these youth unto himself. Today, the youth are leading all sorts of lives, but we know that the Lord is still in control. And we pray, Daniel, when we read verse 8, it tells us that he purposed in his heart that he would not taste the delicacies that will be given unto them. They told them to give them wine, to give them good food, good meat, good drinks, but they looked back that these things are things that they did not take in when they were in their land. So we pray that the Lord will lead our youth to a better place, that the youth will accept Jesus as their shepherd, as their Lord, as their master, that the enemy, whatever the any delicacies that the enemy uses to draw them unto himself, drinks and drugs and food and all that, we pray that the Lord will reveal himself unto them. Because the Bible says that remember your Creator in the days of your youth before the evil days come. We pray that the Lord will reveal himself unto them. Let the light of God shine upon these youth, those who have gone astray, those who would not even listen to their parents, those who have gone wayward, those who are even fighting against their parents. Lord, we pray that you have mercy upon the youth of today. Many are seeking for any foul means to get money, to get rich. But your word says that the hands that do not work, does not work, will not eat. We pray that you lead them through the path of righteousness. We snatch our youth from the hands of the enemy. And we pray, O God, we know that Babylon overcame Judah because Judah sinned against you. We pray that any sort of sin that has brought calamity unto our youth, even if the fault comes from us parents, we pray that you forgive us. Father, forgive us parents, O God, and then cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Help us, O God, to be prayerful people, never to give up, O God, on our children. These young youth, these Jews, Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they went according to their Jewish laws. They went according to what they've been taught. We pray that we'll have, O God, the strength, the boldness to talk about the word of God to the youth. Father, you used Mary, you used Daniel and his friends. Father, you used Timothy, you used so many young people. Oh, we pray that, Lord, you use our youth of today. Let them purpose in their hearts that they will live for you alone. Father, this is our humble prayer that, oh God, we pray committing parents who are weeping, parents who do not even sleep because of their children.
Oh, Lord, have mercy. Father, we pray that you have mercy. You know whatever is going on in every family. We pray that, Lord Jesus, you draw these youth unto yourself like you drew Daniel and his friends unto yourself. We know that when we read further, we will see that because they did not eat that food and they ate vegetables and water, Father, you made them so special. We pray and set our youth apart, O God, for you. Father, we thank you that you have come to our aid and you've had mercy upon us. Thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. Please do not give up, but rather stand in the gap for the youth. God richly bless you and have a fruitful weekend. We'll meet tomorrow too. Bye-bye.